Hi everyone, and welcome to Biology Professor. Today I want to talk to you about the life cycle of a pretty terrible parasite called hookworm. Now, hookworm is a parasite. Specifically, it's a kind of helminth, which means a worm, which we can tell from its name. So hookworm is a parasite. It infects upwards of 800 million people per year globally. So certainly a serious parasite for many people's experiences. The worm is particularly noteworthy because it actually penetrates right through unbroken skin of the host. So a lot of times various pathogens will actually need like a cut in the skin to be able to enter through the skin. Hookworm doesn't need that. It can actually burrow right through healthy, unbroken skin. And ultimately, it lives in the small intestine where it attaches to the intestinal walls, sometimes for years, and sucks the host's blood. Now this leads to some pretty severe side effects resulting from anemia. That is, the blood is sucked. Blood is where a lot of our body's iron is stored. And so hosts get anemia, which is an iron deficiency. And anemia then goes on to cause its own problems, including delayed growth and delayed mental development or sort of mental impairment. Now, we said hookworm is a parasite. Parasite is actually a form of symbiosis, which is where two organisms live in really close contact with each other. In particular, parasitism is what we call a plus-minus form. That means that of the two organisms involved in that symbiotic event, the two organisms here being the hookworm and its host, one of those organisms benefits from the symbiosis. The benefiter here would be the hookworm, and then the other organism is harmed. And of course, in the case of all events of parasitism, the one being harmed is the host. If you are interested in symbiosis and about learning more about parasitism and other forms of symbiosis, including mutualism and commensalism, please see my video on the different types of symbiosis. But to continue here, let's now talk about the life cycle of hookworm. Now, a hookworm infection begins with an egg. Now, hookworm eggs are shed in human feces. So an infected host who has hookworms inside them, their feces will contain huge numbers of hookworm eggs. And this is actually the diagnostic stage, meaning that you can take a fecal sample from a person and actually see under a microscope all of the different eggs in the feces. And so that's how a hookworm infection is typically diagnosed. Now these eggs, excuse me, these eggs, if they make it into soil, they can actually hatch in the warm soil into the next developmental stage, which is larvae. And they need warm soil to do this. And this is why hookworm is typically thought of as a tropical disease, because it's those tropical temperatures that allow the favorable conditions necessary for the eggs to hatch into larvae. Now this early larval form has a particular name. It's called the rugidiform stage of the larvae. Now over the course of a couple of weeks, these rugidiform larvae will mature into a more mature form. The larval stage here is called phalariform. And these larvae can actually survive approximately 3 to 4 weeks in the soil. And that is when conditions are particularly favorable. So like when temperature and moisture conditions are right. Now, it is these phalariform larvae that can actually burrow through the host's skin. So here we have a picture, a drawing of a human foot, and these larvae can actually burrow right through the skin. Now, the larvae are going to be able to burrow through whatever skin is most in contact with the soil, which of course is where they're living. And so typically this is done when a human goes barefoot and has their bare foot in contact with the soil. Now, once this larvae enters the human body, it goes through a really circuitous route. First, it enters the bloodstream. From the bloodstream, it moves to the heart. From the heart, it can travel through the body to the lungs, and then the larvae actually gets coughed up. So it gets coughed up from the lungs up to the pharynx, and then it gets swallowed and goes to the stomach. Then the larvae that survive the stomach acid conditions make it to the small intestines. And it is here in the small intestine where the larvae mature into adults. So the larvae mature into adult worms. These adult worms are the ones that then attach to the lining of the small intestine and suck blood. They can stay there for years. And during the time that they are alive within the body, they're constantly laying eggs, huge, huge numbers of eggs that then get excreted from the human body in the feces. And then the cycle can continue. Now, luckily, hookworm has been all but eradicated in most developed nations. And this is for a few different reasons. First, we have anti-helminthic drugs. So these are drugs that fight worm infections. We can also take iron pills to counteract the anemia that comes from the blood loss. And then we can also break this chain of transmission by doing sort of two main things, encouraging people to wear shoes and making sure that everybody has shoes. This is, of course, a bigger problem in various developing nations. And also we can break this chain of transmission in another place as well, and that's right here, making sure that the human feces that contains the eggs does not actually get into soil. And of course this can be done when countries have proper sanitation and public health infrastructure. And that's why we don't really hear about hookworm in the United States anymore, but certainly it is a bigger problem in many other parts of the world. And you can see that from the number who are infected. Now, if you are interested in learning about other types of parasite life cycles, please see my other video, which is on the life cycle of the parasite that causes the disease schistosomiasis. And that's another kind of worm parasite. So check that one out if you're interested. Thanks for watching, Biology Professor.